Hey everybody.
What's up guys?
It's Real Talk with Keisha
and Tanisha.
And we're here with our episode 12, the last episode. Yeah, last episode in our series of our home buyer series. And today we are going to be talking about finding the perfect home.
Yes, you guys, finding the right home.
Yes.
Very important.
So if you go back to our other the past three episodes, we started off with the pre-gaming strategy. Why should I buy a home?
Yes.
The next episode after that was the neutral zone, how to qualify for a home loan. And the one before this one
yes.
was the line of scrimmage, getting pre-approved.
Yes.
Nisha talked to you about the ins and outs, the credit score, the target credit scores that you need to be looking for if you are trying to get an FHA loan.
Yes.
And if you are trying to get down payment assistance, the magic number.
Sweet spot, what do we call it? The
sweet spot. 640. 640 is the sweet spot. And the sweet spot is the grant money, the free money. If you want to be able to qualify for first-time home buyer assistance, you need to have a minimum 640.
640, guys. 640, yes. 640, 640.
So 580 FHA.
For sure. Absolutely.
On top of the FHA, get the sweet spot money.
Yeah.
640. 640. All right. So today we are talking about finding the perfect home.
Yes.
And we are in our 49er gear.
Hey!
That's how we rip.
That's how we roll. You feeling that? Now,
yes.
Do you guys, okay, so
Cap.
What's going on with Cap? I heard that he's getting looked at again.
Yes.
Which is fantastic.
Did we think he was not going to?
Well, we knew he was going to. We still got an arm on him.
I know there's some haters out there.
There's some haters out there.
Cap is Cap, so we can't take that from him. I know y'all see my nice little hat back there.
That's a joke.
Trying to bring it to the
front. Get this for the crowd. Let's look at this hat you
got. Yes, we are in the house. Yes, don't hate. Don't hate.
Boom.
Hey, I'm not jumping on nobody's train.
Real quick, make sure you guys press the share button.
Yes, press the share button.
Tag your friends. Share button.
Please. Share button.
Yeah.
So we've got some great information. If you take a look in the information section, we've actually posted the next home buyer workshop series that you can register for.
Yes.
Lunch is free.
Lunch is free.
And
guys.
It's going to be put on by Tanisha's company, American Pacific Mortgage. And I've said they've got this thing down to a science.
It's amazing.
It's going to be a great home buyer workshop.
Yes.
So if you are ready to just start looking at what you need to do to prepare, this workshop is a nice way for you to get in there, hear the information directly one-on-one, be able to ask questions, get a free lunch out of it.
Absolutely.
And it's here in South Sacramento.
It is. We do it up.
Yes.
We do it up. So you're going to get a great presentation.
Yes.
With some great information. And you get to eat a little bit, too.
Right, right.
Now,
I was just going to say, in the video, I saw some stuff on top of each desk, so I think they're giving away some stuff.
You might
too.
Get a little bit of goodies.
Might
get yes. And for those of you guys who are new to Real Talk with Keisha and Tanisha, let's introduce ourselves for the crowd.
Yes, my name is Keisha Matthews. I'm the broker owner of Matthews & Company Realty Group and of Urban Core Rentals Property Management, and I am with the Miss Lovely.
Tanisha Broadway, loan officer with American Pacific Mortgage and second vice president of the Sacramento Realtors Organization. How y'all doing?
Hey.
That is hot.
It is. I turned my little fan on, so I hope.
We get a little bit of air, but
if you all see us listening, I know. Yeah.
Okay. I parked probably 2 miles away in the shade because I was not going
to
be having
to keep
a base car
cool
when I
when
get
it's
in
over.
Yeah.
So,
real quick.
Air conditioning is a must.
This hair.
Oh.
So let's just talk about this cut right
here. We're going to get into the information soon.
We are, but I have.
But I got to set the record straight.
This hair right here,
yeah,
that she's rocking right here. She had it first, number
yes.
one. I just want to say that there is someone else who has bit this hairstyle.
There is a very famous,
very
famous person who is flaunting my hairstyle.
She's flaunting her hairstyle.
I just want to set the record straight and let everybody know that I rocked it first.
She had it first.
Yes.
Now, we love Mrs. Taraji.
Yeah,
we love Taraji.
We love
her.
Hers is hot.
It's
really hot. She's got some, I think she got some Indian or something in her because she got some waves going on.
Brought that in a little,
it's
little
pretty cool.
Juices and berries?
Juices and berries.
Okay.
I don't have any juices and berries. This is natural.
She had it first.
Yes.
All of same trendsetters. That's how we do.
Yes.
Boom. So sorry. I just want to get that out there.
Okay.
We can jump into it.
All right. We're going to jump straight into
yes,
it. So we're wrapping it up with the last episode of Finding the Perfect Home.
Yes.
So in football, there's a lot of different ways that you can score. And the number one way to score to gain the most points is a touchdown.
Touchdown.
So in buying a home, a touchdown is the only way you can score. There is no halfway buying a house. There is no partially buying a house. You can't get a few points and buy a house.
Correct.
You need everything in place
all
to
points.
Buy a house. So it's got to be a
six
touchdown.
Points, yeah.
Every single time.
And the two-point conversion. We want all the points.
In place.
Okay.
To make this happen.
Yeah.
So we're going to talk about all the things that you need to have happen during the transaction process so that you can score a touchdown every time. Okay? So we're going to get started with the transaction process, and we're going to go over 7 points. We're going to try to get that all in within the next 10 minutes. We'll talk about establishing financing, a wants and needs list, what you might want in a house, what you might need in a house, setting up your property portal, scheduling showings,
yep.
making an offer, and once the offer is accepted, going into escrow, closing escrow, and moving into your new home. So we're going to try to squeeze all of that in as quickly, as best we can.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
It shows on my page, guys. Okay, so I'm sorry. I'm having a little technical difficulties on my end with my phone.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know.
Right.
Our show's not live on my page. That's weird.
Did I?
It's okay.
I tagged you, dear.
Yeah, I'm tagged.
Y'all make sure you press the share button
press the
so
share.
We can get this going
Please.
To Tanisha's page.
I don't know what's going on.
All right, so we're going to talk about establishing financing.
Yes.
And so Tanisha is going to talk a little bit about that, because before you get into the process of buying a home, we've talked about the things that you need to do to prepare financially.
Yeah.
But now that you've prepared financially, you need to actually sit down with the lender and get pre-qualified. But before you go to your lender, you need to be prepared to ask them some questions.
Has to be.
So we want to prepare. Yeah. We want to equip you with what those questions should be.
It's very important to put a game plan together before you sit with me and put a game plan together. So
right.
you need your own game plan before you leave the house, before you say, I'm going to buy a house. First, you need to figure out what questions do I need to ask the lender? Because there's a lot of things going on. There's a lot of moving parts with the loan process.
Mm-hmm.
And in the very beginning, you need to know where to start. So a couple of questions I think would be important for you to ask yourself. What kind of mortgages are out there? What is available? And what kind of mortgage would I need?
Right.
And so in order to figure out what kind of mortgage you need to look at your situation. Are you a veteran? Possibly. Well, there's VA loans, and maybe you need to ask questions about your VA eligibility.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
because there are different loan types for different categories of people.
Absolutely.
If you didn't know that. So write down some of these questions that Tanisha is going to tell you so that you can ask your lender about them, so that your lender doesn't make the assumption and try to squeeze you into one
yes.
loan type. Because if you're a teacher, a police officer,
yes.
public service
yes.
person, there are special loan programs out there just for
Absolutely.
You.
Absolutely.
If you're a veteran, there are certain loan programs out there for you. So get into as much dialogue as you can with your lender about your occupation, about your past, and specifically ask them, what types of loan programs out there do I qualify
Absolutely.
For?
And then your goals with purchasing a home. Is this going to be the home that you want to spend the rest of your life in?
Mm-hmm.
Is this a short-term goal?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then there's different loan options and different time frames that will correspond to what your plans are.
Right.
And these are things that you need to be thinking about. Maybe you want to buy an investment property. Well, that's a different type of loan.
Right. Yes.
You know.
So letting your lender know what your goals are with your purchase will help them determine what's the best loan type for you. So
Absolutely.
Write that question down.
That
Any
down.
Other good question they should ask their lender?
Well, you know, you want to talk about costs. So you want to get an idea of the costs that are associated with the loan, because there's a lot of costs. And so you need to figure out, you know, what are you willing to pay, or what do you feel like is you need to provide as far as
what do you have saved up?
What do you have saved
yeah.
up?
What, can you
what
save
do
up?
I need? How much money do I need?
Right.
Or
yes.
do I need any money?
Right.
These are some questions. Definitely write those down. Talking about how much money do I need down? Do I even need money down? What options
total,
are
yeah. total, not just
total.
Closing costs, but out the door
yeah.
by the time the transaction is over, how much money will you need?
Yeah.
That's a question for your lender.
Absolutely. Those are the two main ones I think I want to touch on.
Okay.
What else? Possibly there's, okay. Oh, this is a good one on my notes here. Credit issues, past credit issues, right? So when I pull your credit, I'm going to see what's going on.
Hmm.
But it's good to write down some questions about what's going on in your credit. You may have a verbal agreement with a company about something that's going on in your credit that I don't know about,
mm-hmm.
that maybe when I run your information through our system and it says, no, they can't qualify. Well, had I known about an arrangement that you have, you know, that I don't see on your credit, that may change the outcome that I'm able to provide. So
do you know what that makes me think of?
Yes.
Sometimes people think, oh, I'm not going to tell the lender all of that because
yes.
they don't need to know.
Yes.
But based on what she just said, this is why you need to have a relationship with a lender that you're very comfortable
Absolutely.
With, because they need to know it all.
Gotta know it all.
If you've got hidden properties over in a small country somewhere, your lender needs to know.
I need to know that if you have money and it's under your mattress and not in a bank account, I need to know that before we get to the closing.
Right.
Now,
yes.
Fortunately, with American Pacific Mortgage, one of the disclosures we have up front is proof of funds. So I have to know, like, day one, where's the money at? Where's it coming from?
Right.
Where's it at?
A lot of people keep a lot of cash under their mattresses.
They really, really do.
Mattresses.
They really do. I can't blame you for that. But when it comes to purchasing a home, you got to be able to source that money, and it can't just be cash laying around.
So that money will eventually need to touch a bank account before the transaction is over. So talk to your lender about that if you're storing money. So have that conversation. That's another question you should write down.
And then, of course, the obtaining new debt, if you're thinking about maybe making a purchase, that's something you want to talk to me about before you go do it. A lot of people think, well, you know what? I mean, I'm gonna go buy a car, you know,
before I buy my house.
Before I buy my house. Maybe I need a couple credit cards.
But you just jacked up your credit.
You just jacked it up.
Yeah.
Tell me what you want to do. Yeah. Ask me. Tanisha,
so that she can tell you no.
So I can say no.
Because that's what's
going to
happen.
I'm going to say no. I'm going to say don't do it. Yeah. I don't even want to tell you how many of these situations I deal with on a regular basis.
Yeah.
You guys have to listen out there.
Yeah.
Don't make any purchases, okay?
Right.
In the process before or during.
Right.
Before or during. Don't buy
when
anything.
You're buying a home, it's time to bog down. It's time to manage.
Also, don't go on vacation in the middle of the process. Please don't do that. Don't do it. That's going to be stressful for everyone. So that's my 3 cents on some questions to write down. Let's see. Anything else I can think of that's pretty strong? Required documents. That's one that's important.
Oh.
So there's going to be a list of documents that I'm going to send you a checklist of the things that you need to provide in order for me to get you pre-approved.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're missing something or you're going to have a challenge providing something, then tell me up front. Let me know so that we can plan early to get these things handled. Because the last thing we want to do is you know, maybe you thought you had your tax returns and you didn't say anything to me about it.
Yeah.
And I'm requesting them and time's going by. Now you're in escrow.
Right.
I still haven't got your tax returns. Mm-hmm. You're telling me you have them. And I'm like, where are they at? Well, I could have handled that really on. I could have ordered your tax transcripts really in the very, very beginning.
Right.
You know, if you told me, hey, Tanisha, I just don't flat out, I'm not going to have these. I'm not going to find them, just to avoid problems. So ask me, Tanisha, what do I need? Here's the list that I'm giving you. But in addition to that, you may have a special circumstance. Maybe you filed a BK, you know, six years ago with discharge, and the, you know, and maybe you want to know about that, even though with FHA, the guidelines are a little more lax, but I still need to know these things.
Right.
So just write down questions about your personal credit situation, your financial situation, your what else? Just anything pertaining to the loan or anything pertaining to your credit. Write the questions down. Mm-hmm. Let me know, and we'll get you going.
Yeah. So disclose everything.
Disclose
I think what I got out of that was that there is nothing that you should keep from your lender because it will be found out, and it's better to get it out up front so that it can be worked on early.
Yes.
If it happens in the end, then it will cause a delay in the transaction and there could be ramifications for that and just a lot of unnecessary undue stress. And you want the transaction to be a nice experience for yourself.
You want it to be smooth.
So get it all out in the beginning.
The 11th hour surprises aren't good for anybody.
Yeah.
They're not. And we want to make this transaction.
Thank you for sharing, Miss Katina.
Hey, sis. She shared.
Somebody else shared too. Thank you for sharing.
I just turned off our little football music.
So we want to talk next about the wants and needs list.
Yes.
So that's the exciting part. So when you're buying a house, it should just be just a moment, a time where you're very, very happy. It shouldn't be a time of stress.
No.
Sometimes stress does enter the picture, but the wants and needs part of it is really the exciting part. So you want to talk with your agent about what you want and what you need. And there is a difference.
Oh, there's a difference. Oh,
she got excited about that.
There's a difference.
There's
you know, we all know we have that wants and needs list.
Yeah,
okay?
Yeah.
I love them shoes.
Yes.
I want them.
Yeah.
But do I need them?
Yes.
Same situation.
And what is that saying? People have Beverly Hills taste on a Compton budget. And it's kind of, you know, we really want to have the nicest of everything. But when you're buying a house, sometimes if you're a first-time home buyer, you can't get that last home. You know, this is the first purchase.
Yes.
So you got to be reasonable and rational. And just to be able to purchase and get in the game, is a huge step. That's you know, huge. It may not be exactly where you want. It may not look exactly what you want it to look like, but it's yours and can't nobody put you out.
Nope.
Unless you don't pay the mortgage.
Well, then that's it.
So a wants and needs list, what that looks like is you're telling your agent that you want a minimum certain amount of bedrooms, a minimum certain amount of bathrooms, a minimum size square footage. Perhaps it's the neighborhood. After you spoke with your lender, you're letting your agent know what your maximum price point is. And then they set you up on a property portal through MLS, and properties will be, the portal will be created according to your specification, and properties will generate to your email according to what you specify. So your agent can change that. And it's just the same as if you go on to Zillow or Trulia or Redfin or Realtor and you're looking on your own. The difference is you're getting it straight from MLS in real time.
Real time.
It's not lagging. Yep. It's the truth.
Yep.
And it is according to what you want.
Yep.
So if you're getting property in, if you're not getting property in and you're seeing it on another website, then that means you need to modify your portal because the property that you're looking at on another website does not have the same specification that you specified in your portal.
Absolutely.
So creating a wants and needs list, that's the first thing that you'll do. And we just talked about the property portal. That comes from MLS. It is very current. It is the most updated and accurate information. If an agent lists a property at 1 o'clock in the morning and it meets your criteria, boom.
Boom.
It's going straight into your email at 1 o'clock in the morning.
Boom.
Zillow and Redfin can't do that.
Keisha, I want to see this house. It's 2 a.m. I know, but I want to see it at 6.
Keisha, you just sent me a property. No, I didn't. At 1 o'clock in the morning.
But I see this.
I'm asleep. It's an automatic send that gets sent to you because it's real time.
Yeah.
So that's what MLS does. So once you get the properties that you want to see, you'll talk to your agent about scheduling showings. The way that we work with our system, I have my assistant that is always queued in on our with our clients, and we're asking our clients, hey, whatever you want to see, let us know in advance so that we can contact the listing agent, schedule the appointments according to your availability, and we'll go out and see it. Sometimes we're out showing at least three to five properties a week for each buyer, because my goal is to get our clients into escrow within a month, less than a month. Sometimes it can happen in a couple of weeks, but sometimes there's a little bit of a learning curve, because the market is a little different now,
a little different,
and buyers come into this buying market with their own ideas, or family members are telling them what to expect.
Yeah.
But if you have a good agent, that agent's going to sit down and educate you about this current market.
Yes.
The market itself changes. It's seasonal and cyclical.
Yeah.
So right now, it is a seller's market.
Seller's market.
So as a buyer, your agent should be educating you on coming in and making a strong offer every time out the gate and how to do that. I'm not going to go into details on that right now because we are just a couple minutes away from us wanting to shut the program down because we don't want to hold you guys too long.
We know you love us, though.
But not 25 minutes worth, so we're going to shut it down soon. Make sure you press the share button
share.
So that your friends get this information.
Please.
Remember to register for the workshop.
Register
the information is there, posted. And the last thing I want to talk about is making an offer, getting your offer accepted, and going in and closing escrow.
Hey.
So once you find a house that you love, you get with your agent, you decide you want to make an offer, that offer is made, contractual time frames begin, and those contractual time frames on average are about 30 days. An average escrow is about 30 days. So you have 30 days to do everything that you say you're going to do in your contract. Your agent will walk you through all of that. If you've got a great agent, you don't have to worry about how to get all the paperwork together.
Correct.
What do I need to sign? The only thing you need to worry about is reading the documentation, understanding the documentation, agreeing to the documentation, and signing off on the documentation.
Not on that line.
That's all you have to do. So a good agent is going to walk you through the process from the beginning, where you are turning in your earnest money deposit into escrow. You're scheduling your inspections next. The inspections are occurring. You are reviewing the inspection reports. At the same time, the lender has ordered the appraisal.
Yes.
They've submitted your funding package to underwriting after they've collected all the documents, because you turned in all of your documents on time.
You had your questions ready to go. There was no problems. We were smooth sailing. You had your pre-approval done early, which you provided to her so that she was confident in showing you properties knowing that you were fully approved, which is the very first step.
Exactly.
Which we talked about in our first one.
First episode.
Get pre-approved first.
Yes. So
before
with
you
that
think about
flow,
yeah.
Because you were so ready, we're now flowing through the escrow process. Yes. The loan is being processed. The inspections are done. You're reviewing your inspections. You're saying what you like and don't like. We go back and we ask the sellers to make a couple of repairs. In a perfect world, the seller says, I'll make all of those
repairs for you. I don't even trip.
Yes, they're going to fix everything. That don't always happen. But we're just in a good world. We're going to say they're going to fix everything. So if they fix everything, then we say, wow, we're going to release all the contingencies. Everything that we had initially said in our offer was contingent upon us buying this house. We weren't going to buy this house until all this stuff was done. Guess what? Now all of this stuff is done. We're releasing contingency.
Hey.
We're moving forward to closing escrow.
Let's go.
So we get to the last stage. You'll hear a term called DOCS.
DOCS.
D-O-C-S.
Oh, we love that term.
Yes.
Oh, it's a happy, exciting, frightening, and crazy term all at the same time.
DOCS. You're going to love the DOCS phase.
Oh, you're going to love it.
There's one DOC in particular that you're going to love. It's called the CD.
The
closing disclosure. Everything stops for 3 days. For how many days?
3 days.
Everything stops for 3 days when you get sent the closing disclosure. The closing disclosure outlines all of your financial terms, how much you're going to pay, what your interest rate is going to be, so on and so forth. And you have to read that, and you have to agree that that is the same number, and those are the same terms that you agreed to when you started the process.
Absolutely.
If anything changes or if anything is different, we start all over, not the entire process.
No.
We start that has to be corrected, sent back into underwriting. And we have to issue another CD and wait 3 more days until we get it right.
3 more days.
I've never had a situation. Well, actually, I take that back. I just had a situation where the CD was not correct.
Okay.
The buyer's lender wasn't somebody that I was representing. I was representing the seller. Mm. The buyer's CD initially came out saying they were bringing in $14,000 to close. Mm. The CD came back out a second time saying that they were bringing in $19,000 to close.
Oh, gosh, numbers are going up.
So when stuff like that happens, you know, it's got to get fixed. So anyway, the CD is very important. It's very important that everything stops. Everything gets placed on a hold until that CD is correct according to what you want it to be.
Absolutely.
So that's to protect you.
It's to protect the consumer.
Then we get to docs. The doc signing usually takes about 1 hour. Mm-hmm. Typically, your agent should be there. Your lender sometimes will be there because there may be questions that you'll have.
Absolutely.
You'll be signing a stack of papers.
About that big. Yeah.
For real.
Yeah.
And it'll take about an hour, but with a good escrow officer or a good doc signer, notary, you'll get through it in no time.
Boom. Yeah, that's the plan. So unless you have a bunch of questions, like she said, and I'm present at my signings, so things happen. And a lot of these documents you would have already signed and some of your disclosures that you would have already signed.
Yeah.
But it's just important. I mean, it's a big setup buying a house. And there's a lot of moving parts, like I said. And so you want to feel confident. You want to feel good about those docs. You want to make sure there's no problems.
Yeah.
And I want to be a resource if there is a problem right then and there. If you don't understand something, we want to handle it right there. But those docs, when they come out, you that plane has landed.
Yes. When the docs come in.
Yeah.
It's a very happy day for everybody. So I even take pictures of my clients when they're at their doc signing.
Yes.
It's just a wonderful event.
Yeah.
So once we get past the doc signing, those docs get signed, they get sent back to the lender. And what happens when they go back to the lender?
Well, we're doing our funding conditions. Hopefully, in a perfect world, there aren't any. Now, we probably were simultaneously doing our funding conditions when you were signing docs. So all these things happen at the same time. Mm-hmm. And if all our checks and balances go into place, then we're funding this loan. We're recording this deal all in the same day.
Yeah, that would be. And in a perfect world, it happens very quickly.
Really
you're signing one day and the next day you've got keys. But the reality is that sometimes there are setbacks. So that could take an additional day or two. But never longer than that.
No.
In a normal transaction.
Yeah.
If it's a weird transaction, then it's longer than that. But weird transactions are rare. Normal transactions are about 24, 48 hours, and then you've closed escrow. The lender funds in the morning, title records in the evening,
yep.
And you are a new homeowner. Process on average takes about 30 days.
30 days, yes.
So if you'd like to experience that for yourself personally, the way to get started is by signing up for that home buyer's workshop.
Yes, guys,
and again, remember in the comments section, if you register, say yep. that you heard about it from Real Talk with Keisha
and Tanisha.
All right, so okay. We really enjoyed our time.
Yes, we did.
This
Thank
is the
you
last
guys.
Of our series
it's
here.
It's the last of our series, not the last of Real Talk with Keisha
yeah,
and Tanisha.
It's the last of our home buyers.
We will come back with something our next session, so
yes.
Don't even trip. We
yes.
got something for you guys.
We're representing the Niners, and
Yay.
If you represent somebody else, that's okay. We still love
cool.
you, but we love the Niners,
we love
and we don't bandwagon.
And we love
we
cats.
We're for life.
Yes.
We love cats. So.
And we love her hair.
And we love my hat.
We love that hat.
Yes.
Guys.
Yes.
And
we love you.
We love you.
Oh my God, we do.
Yes.
Oh my God. All right, you guys, well, make sure you stay tagged and tuned in to Real Talk with
Keisha
and Tanisha.
Where
we bring
you. We bring you. We messed that up.
Hey.
Take two.
Okay.
Make sure that you stay tagged and tuned in to Real Talk with Keisha
and Tanisha,
where we bring you positively
positive
real talk about real estate and more.
Girl, look, we
Bye.
Live on here. It don't even matter.
Bye, y'all.
Bye.
Oh, that was too funny.